Welcome back to our latest royal discussion. Today, we're delving into a particularly intriguing topic that has been stirring conversations across the nation, the late Queen's handling of the Meghan Markle situation and the ensuing Archie and Lilibet drama. Now, let's get straight to the heart of the matter. The passing of the Queen undoubtedly brought the country together in a profound expression of sorrow. We all witnessed her state funeral, a majestic and heart-wrenching event, paying tribute to a monarch whose reign was the longest in British history. Her departure from this world was not just the end of an era, but also a moment that highlighted her significant impact and the deep affection people had for her. But here's where things get intriguing. The royal family, as you might be aware, doesn't just welcome anyone into its fold. There's a rigorous process involved, especially for those looking to marry into the royalty. This brings us to Meghan Markle. Back in March 2016, something quite routine happened. MI5, the UK's domestic counterintelligence and security agency, handed over a confidential report about Meghan to the Queen. This is standard for anyone who aspires to be part of the royal family or even the royal household staff. This report wasn't just a formality. It was a comprehensive examination of Meghan's background, including checks on her criminal record, political affiliations, past relationships, and even her family's history. It's a level of scrutiny that's heightened for those who seek to marry into the royal family, far more intense than the checks for prospective employees. So, what was going through the Queen's mind when she read through Meghan's file? It's a thought-provoking question. The Queen wouldn't have reviewed this dossier in isolation. She would have had her courtiers and possibly some government officials with her, dissecting every detail. It's reminiscent of the past, like the story of Captain Peter Townsend and Princess. Moving on to another chapter in royal history, let's take a moment to reflect on Princess Margaret's romance with Captain Peter Townsend. Their love story unfolded during an era when the Church of England strongly opposed remarriage after divorce. Princess Margaret, needing her sister the Queen's approval to marry, faced a heartbreaking decision when the Queen, adhering to the Church's stance, did not approve her marriage to Townsend due to his previous divorce. Similarly, we can't forget about Prince Andrew and actress Kew Stark. It's widely speculated that Stark's controversial past played a role in the Queen advising her son against pursuing a relationship with her. Over the years, there have been instances where the Queen appeared to intervene in the personal relationships of royal family members, some of which might still raise eyebrows even in today's more open society. This brings us back to Meghan Markle. Armed with an exhaustive background report on Meghan and her family, questions arise as to why the Queen consented to Prince Harry's marriage to her. Intriguingly, it's rumored that not long after giving her blessing, the Queen instructed her courtiers to avoid mentioning Meghan's name in her presence. A royal expert is curious about the timeline here. How soon after the wedding did the Queen allegedly start referring to Meghan in unflattering terms? The controversy doesn't end there. Claims have been made suggesting the Queen was informed that Meghan's pregnancy with Archie was fabricated. Yet, the Queen didn't publicly address these rumors. Could she have thought that simply asking Meghan to leave the country would put an end to the drama? Meghan's conduct, particularly her exaggerated, mocking curtsy on television, which was seen as a sign of disrespect towards the Queen, added fuel to the fire. This act reportedly left Prince Charles bewildered and questioning her motives. The royal expert concludes by addressing the public's perception of deceit within the royal family, particularly concerning the existence of Meghan and Harry's children. The decision to include their names in the royal lineage has raised many eyebrows. Let's delve deeper into the royal narrative. It was June 4, 2021, when Meghan was said to have given birth to their second child, Lilibet. However, an interesting turn of events occurred when neither Archie nor Lilibet were initially listed in the royal line of succession. Questions were raised, debates ensued. What was the reason behind this delay? Flash forward to late July, as the Queen prepared for her traditional summer getaway to Balmoral Castle. Upon her arrival, a flood of correspondence from various online groups awaited her, all echoing a similar sentiment about Meghan's alleged deceit and its impact on the line of succession. It wasn't long after that when the names of Meghan and Harry's children were finally slotted into the line of succession, tucked between the Duke of Sussex and the Duke of York. This sudden inclusion, without any formal explanation, sparked further curiosity and debate. Now, let's ponder over a crucial question. Did the late Queen play a role in silencing the media regarding Meghan's supposed deceit? Some suggest that her actions were a strategic move to protect the monarchy from scandal. It's worth noting that the dynamics of royal permissions and public obedience have evolved over time. Regardless of the Queen's stance, it seemed likely that Harry would have married Meghan, with or without royal consent. This union, challenged by controversy, raised complex issues, including accusations of racism. Meghan's influence on Harry painted a picture of an inescapable scenario, leading to inevitable scandal. Comparisons are even drawn with historical figures like Wallace Simpson, albeit in a more extreme light. The royal family, unprepared for a figure like Meghan, found themselves in a dilemma. The notion of appeasement. Diving into the depths of this royal saga, it's clear that the situation involving Meghan and the royal family is complex and fraught with controversy. The idea that appeasement could have been a solution seems, in hindsight, to have been a miscalculation. The story takes another twist with rumors circulating that Meghan had informed the Queen of her pregnancy prior to her marriage to Harry, only to later claim a loss. This narrative suggests that Meghan used the prospect of motherhood as a means to strengthen her position within the royal family. The birth of Archie, followed by the announcement of Lilibet's arrival, only added layers to the unfolding drama. The Queen's response to these developments was to reportedly ask Harry and Meghan to leave the UK, leading to their initial move to Canada and subsequent relocation to California. This move, however, didn't seem to deter Meghan from pursuing her alleged agenda. Harry, often described as a loose cannon, presented a unique challenge to the Queen. It's speculated that she hoped Meghan's past, considered unsavory by some, might be redeemed through royal life, thereby placating Harry and maintaining family stability. However, the situation escalated beyond simple redemption narratives. Despite extensive investigations by MI5 into Meghan's background, it appears that the royal family was unprepared for the subsequent events. Now, with Meghan and Harry in America, there's a sense within the royal circles that the distance might limit any further impact on the family. Yet, Meghan's actions and public image continue to fuel discussions and speculations. Meghan's public persona has been a topic of intense debate, with opinions sharply divided. Described by some as greedy and unpopular, she has undoubtedly left a significant mark on the royal family and public perception. In the unfolding royal drama, the situation with Meghan and Harry has reached a critical point. The prevailing sentiment in some quarters is that the royal family should distance themselves entirely from the couple. With numerous accusations leveled against Meghan, including dishonesty, the idea of removing any royal titles and succession rights from the couple's children has gained traction. This action, some argue, would significantly diminish Meghan's influence and status. The suggestion that King Charles should address the public directly and disclose the full story about Meghan and Harry is gaining momentum. The belief is that such transparency might actually bolster the monarchy's standing, with the public likely to sympathize with the royal family's predicament. In this complex web of accusations and family dynamics, both Meghan and Harry are seen as culpable by some, with neither deserving absolution. This ongoing saga raises important questions about the future of the monarchy, the role of the media, and the public's perception of royal affairs. The case of Meghan and Harry is not just a family issue but one that resonates with broader societal themes of truth, responsibility, and public image. As we continue to observe this evolving story, it's clear that the implications extend far beyond the walls of the palace. It's a tale of modern royalty, media, and the public eye that will undoubtedly continue to captivate and provoke discussion.